Sum anchoing
anchoing. The President, please be seated.
Veuillez vous asseoir.
The trial chamber is back in session for today.
And première instance reprend son audience.
This morning and tomorrow, we will conduct the hearing on the facts the operation of Presor, which is part of S21. And before we begin our program, I would like to remind the parties to this proceedings, please be informed that at the request of the interpreters, requesting all of you that to use your effort to speak more slowly, so that the interpreters could provide accurate, clear interpretations, so that the trial chamber and the conduct of the hearing and the transcript should be recorded properly and accurate.
Cela aussi permettra d'établir des
in addition to that, I have a concern that I am the one who, on the request for the fast speaker, so some of the
Je
parties were mentioned by the name to speak more slowly so that we can go smoothly. The security officer, please bring the accused to the dock.
Je vous appelle tous à faire un effort de discipline sur ce plan. Je demande au garde de sécurité d'amener l'accusé à la barre.
Please, Mr. Co-prosecutor, the floor is yours.
C'est intervenir, je vous en prie.
Good morning, Mr. President, Your Honours, Counsel. Your Honour, just a brief administrative matter. After the trial management meeting yesterday, or during it, you advised us that the witnesses, the witness phase of the case will start on Monday. And you also advised us that we had 1 hour of questioning with the accused and similarly with the other parties. I would ask that after the questioning of the trial chamber, whether it was possible today, whether it was possible that the questioning start tomorrow morning from the party's perspective. And the reason why I ask that is, as your honours have rightly done, and we welcome that, you've provided the parties fairly strict time constraints with questioning. And as it's the last phase of this case, I would ask that we be able to review your honours' questions so that we don't ask repetitive questions tomorrow morning.
That's a brief aujourd'hui à l'accusé pour ne pas répéter ces questions demain. C'est pourquoi nous demandons à poser nos propres questions à partir de demain matin. Merci.
And your honours, if I can at least on behalf of my group support that request, because again you gave only 1 hour for civil parties on that topic, so that will require some coordination on our side. So we would be grateful if we could have some time to review, and we would be ready tomorrow morning if you do finish today, but we would request not to start today if possible.
We're grateful. Donc ne pas poser nos questions aujourd'hui mais attendre demain. Merci.
The President, the trial chamber take notes of this request, and we consider that the proposal is appropriate and sustained, and so that you can prepare your question to avoid repetition question and some question that might be might not fall in the facts discussed, and we will spend less time and straight to the point. And the trial chamber made its study on these facts, and one day for this fact it would be sufficient for the questionings, because the facts it is a part of the S21, but it is limited. And when we look into the closing order, the trial chamber, as mentioned today, it may be we can use only one day for this fact, but in fact it might be not even one day, or one morning, or a little bit in the afternoon, and tomorrow we and for today and tomorrow we will focus on this facts, and we keep the next week for the hearing of the survivors, so that we have enough possibility to proceed with these facts. So we decide to receive your request.
Votre requête est par conséquent acceptée.
The President, the accused, once again, the trial chamber would like to inform you that the trial chamber will question you about the facts at Presor called S24 and about its establishment and the operations. This is the subject for today's hearing.
C'est le sujet de l'audition de l'audience d'aujourd'hui.
Mr. Kang Kek-il, was Presor a part of S21 in Phnom Penh?
De S21 à Phnom Penh.
The accused, Mr. President, S21, since I became the chairman, there were three places. The first was S21 in Phnom Penh, second, the killing field at Chung Ek, the third, it was the re-education place at Presor. In the past, when Nat was the chief, he called it as S24 for Presor. I agreed with the trial chamber to use the term, the name S24 as Presor, but I would like to confirm that it is a section or part of S21. It is under my supervision. That's all.
De quelque chose qui faisait partie intégrante de S21 et que je supervisais donc.
The President, question. The real name of Presor, so we call it by its name at that time. What was it?
Quel était le nom utilisé pour désigner
Presor? The accused, Mr. President.
Réponse.
The name recognized by the Standing Committee of the Central
du PCK,
Party, it was called, the three places it's called S21, including S21 at Phnom Penh, at Chung Ek, and the re-education camp at Presor.
But
in the internal affair of S21, not called it as S24, and I also recognize S21 as Presor, but it is under my control. It was absolutely under my control.
That's all. Une supervision sur S24.
The President. So it means that the security office S24 or Presor was established in the same time of S21.
Le camp de S24 a été établi en même temps que S21.
Is that true? the accused, Mr.
Réponse.
President, it is true.
Oui, c'est exact, Monsieur le Président.
The President, you said a while ago that you were the chairman for all places, including the re-education place at Presor S24. Do you remember and can you tell the chamber about the structure, the management structure
at, en place pour gérer
at office S24 or Presor? The accused, Mr. President, at the beginning, I would like to tell you that S21 was created since NAT, I'm sorry, when NAT created the security office for Division 703, Nopon Al-Yassop was purged. A number of people who were not decided by the party were sent to a place for re-education. So it continues since then. When S21 was officially created and when I became the deputy chief for Presor, it was also under my supervision in my capacity as a deputy. And when Nat was there as the chairman, Comrade Hui, his former name is Nun Hui, was one of the members of the S21 committee. At that time, Nat assigned one person to be responsible as a deputy of Nun Hui. His name is Yu Peng Kri, just Mon at Presor, but later Comrade Mon Nu Peng Kri, just Nu Peng Kri, was purged and only Comrade Hui was there. In addition to that, every now and then, I asked Comrade Paul to help the work of Comrade Hui. So the one who was always there on my behalf and on the behalf of the S21 committee at Presor was Comrade Hor. And the three of us, we were together and we implemented the party policy against the enemy and re-education at Presor. That's all I can tell you, Mr. President. When you were the chief of also the re-education camp at Presor, did you know the size and the geographical area under your control? And the survivor of from that place, they said that, and if you look into the place that they live, it seemed to be far from Presor. So one of the survivors said that he was from Kropeha Pagoda, and it was part of Presor. What can you say about the geographical area of Presor at that time?
Couverte par Presor à l'époque.
The accused, Mr. President. I do not know about the existence of that pagoda. But when I went to Presor, I went to the house of Comrade Hui next to the edge of the stream named Long Kong. One time I went there, I met Comrade Hui, who was planting the sweet potatoes at that time, and Baku was not in Praise Center, it was belonged to Baku, Division 703.
Appartenait à la 703e division, ne faisait pas partie de Praise.
I can describe briefly the geography when I went there. When you are talking about the rice paddy and rice field, it had a small rice paddy. It had the same size of rice paddies for the tailor's unit. There was a map at the general staff, but I could not find that map. But the area was not so large. You are talking about that pagoda, but I don't know whether it was part of Presor, that song. The president on Long Kong and the former Praisor prison, how far from Praisor it was?
Quelle est la distance?
The accused, Mr. President, talking about the distance estimation, I could not make that estimation, but it is far. One is on the to the south, another one is at the northeast. I could not make estimation, but it's not more than 10 kilometers. It was about, it's the maximum, maybe 5 kilometers from each other. That's all I can tell you. The president, thank you. At that time, the former Praisor prison from the old regime, did you use any purpose for the Praisor re-education center?
Du camp de rééducation
S24. The accused, Mr. President, the former Praisor prison, we did not use it.
N'était pas utilisé.
Personally, I went to see some souvenir that I was detained there. There was nothing that we used, nothing there.
Souvenir.
And myself and the S21 committee members, we decided not to use the former prison of Lonel, so we abandoned it. Why did we decide that? Because we do not have waters. This is the most important thing.
C'était le point le plus important.
That's all I can tell you, Mr. President. Mr. the President, can you tell the chamber that what were the important roles of the re-education center of Praisor, what were the roles and missions?
Quelle était la mission de ce centre?
The accused, Mr. President, the main roles and function and the most basic function were to keep the combatant who have problem or trouble, who were almost arrested for detention or interrogation and torture and smash, but they did not make that final decision, and they send those combatants there. They call the element units, as called at that time. That's all I can tell you briefly, Mr. President.
What about the regime of making reports? That is the reporting of the activities of the re-education center. Was the report directly sent to the upper echelon, or the report has to go through you, and then you would report to the upper echelon or to the standing committee, or to your superior, Sun Sen, and later on Nunchie.
Et par la suite à Nunchie.
The accused.
Réponse.
Mr. President, the unit of elements was designated by the standing committee,
they lose their right as civilians. Permanent. Les gens qui s'y trouvaient perdaient leurs droits
so
en tant que civils.
The decision to smash
la décision
was,
was
made halfway already.
Les personnes qui s'y trouvaient étaient déjà à moitié prises.
And the order was made to the S21 committee.
Et instruction était donné au comité directeur de S21.
And actually it was delivered to the committee of the 703 division.
Au comité
every day, Comrade
Pui
sent me the report on the number of elements who were sick and for those who could work.
Malade,
particularly
valide,
regarding the incidents.
Il me rendait compte des incidents Comrade qui pouvaient avoir lieu et
Comrade
Hui report to Comrade
Ho,
rendait compte sur ce plan à Comrade
practice
Ho.
Was done before even when I became the chairman.
C'est une pratique qui a été instaurée avant même que
so
je devienne directeur
this
de S21.
About the authority.
Voilà donc pour ce qui était
if
de l'autorité conférée aux uns et aux autres. Si on compare Pressor
to the M13B, it was
M13B,
different. At M13B, people would be detained for 1 week just as a deterrence, and then they were released. But the situation
libérés.
Was different at Pressor. Since its establishment, the unit of elements were never transformed into the ordinary civilians or combatants again.
Composé d'éléments,
this
comme
is
on
my
les appelait.
Response, Your Honor.
Ces éléments n'étaient jamais de nouveau considérés comme des civils.
You
question.
Stated the important roles of the re-education center
de Pressor,
that is to re-educate the male and female youths
les jeunes, hommes ou femmes,
who made an offense,
qui avaient
and their offense was decided halfway towards the smash,
et qui avaient échappé à l'exécution.
However, in the case file,
et dans le dossier,
there were other types of people
on trouve d'autres catégories
who
de personnes
were kept at the re-education center at Pressor.
Confinés au centre de rééducation
can you
de Pressor.
Describe the other elements of people who were sent to
Pressor
for re-education?
Pour rééducation?
The accused, Mr.
Réponse.
President. The other elements who were sent for re-education, for the first batch, it was just an experiment, and there were about 30 or 30 plus of them. At that time, my superior, Sun Saint, brought the combatants from the east zone to try to experiment on the re-education, and that happened once. They were from the tanks unit. So after 1 month,
après un mois,
he instructed me to release them
m'a donné instruction de relâcher ces personnes
and to have them into the tanks unit, which was newly established, and I implemented his decision. So that was the first experiment. For those
groupe.
Who were the elements outside the 703 division.
Pour les éléments
however, based on the surviving document,
mais sur la base des documents
it is shown that the elements
que
from Office 62 and Office 63 from of the logistics office, from the general staff,
de
Comrade Sok or Sundara, who was the secretary of the secret force in Phnom Penh. So his group and his relatives were also sent by my superior, including
Mai
Lun, and his relatives were also sent to prison. Mai Lun and Kamrat Sok and his wife were smashed.
Avec leur femme ont
so
été
this
exécutés.
Is in the surviving document.
Cela, ce sont des éléments que l'on retrouve dans
before
les
documents
there was
a measure on them, and other need to be sought from him. This is from my recollection. And because I saw that document,
haut,
I could say that the people in
prison
was originally the members of the 703 divisions, but then later on, based on the surviving documents, then members of the general staff were also sent there. There might be other members of other units who were sent there, even from Phnom Penh, but I am not clear. If there are surviving documents to show, then I can confirm that. However, I could say that no member or elements from the countryside were sent to Prisor. It might be possible that members from various units in Phnom Penh were sent to but mostly, maybe the units from the Central Army.
Essentiellement,
there were nine divisions within the Central Army, and three
regiments.
So, probably the people or the elements at Prisor might have come from those units. This is just my conclusion, Your Honor.
Voilà en tout cas ce que j'ai pu conclure.
The President,
question.
However, we also saw some elements.
Nous avons pourtant vu,
for example,
d'autres gens
family
appresseurs,
members
par exemple, des membres des familles,
of the subordinates who were arrested and sent
to
S21, who were the former S21 staff. Some of them were brought there, including the rest of the family members.
Certains membres du personnel ont donc été emmenés à S24 avec leur famille parfois.
So sometimes, based on the documents, the husbands were sent to S21 and smashed, and the family members were sent to prison.
Un membre du personnel a pu aussi
and
être
sometimes
exécuté à
also the subordinates were also sent to prison. Were there such cases?
Est-ce que vous pouvez confirmer ces faits?
The accused,
réponse.
Mr. President, I cannot deny it. If there are any surviving documents,
si
it would be beneficial to read the documents. However, from my recollection, the important cadres, for example, Von Weidt, when he was arrested, Brother Wundt was also arrested, that's his wife, and also his children. So I cannot make any conclusion as which cadres would be delivered to me by the superior for the detention at S21 in Phnom Penh, and who else
tandis que d'autres
would be sent to Prisor, I mean the family members of those who were arrested and detained at S21.
Je ne me souviens pas de cas de ce genre.
The President, the people who were sent for re-education
les personnes envoyées pour être rééduquées à Prisor.
Were there women and children?
S'agissait-il de femmes et d'enfants?
The accused, Mr. President.
Réponse.
The people who were sent for re-education at Prisor, from my recollection, initially they were the male and female combatants from the 703 divisions. So they were purely male and female combatants, and the supervising cadres there only had a wife, that is, Yut Penkri alias Hun. So that was what happened at the time. And about the 160 children in the list written by Comrade Ho were the children who were separated from their parents in Phnom Penh, and they were kept temporarily in
Prisor.
The president.
Question.
The women who were kept for re-education in prison, were there any pregnant women?
Incarcérées après ça, parmi ces femmes,
the accused, Mr. President,
enceintes?
When I was the chairman of the overall S21, I did not have the figure, but based on the surviving documents, yes, there were some pregnant women
si l'on kept there. Les documents qui ont survécu, on
the
peut vous constater
president.
Que certaines des femmes étaient enceintes.
The court officer,
question.
You take these documents to survey
Monsieur
to the accused.
Veuillez montrer ces documents à l'accusé, s'il vous plaît.
The co-prosecutor, can you project on the screen a document EAN in Khmer 00 00 00 00 7270? Can you do that?
7270 en Khmer.
The audio and visual unit, can you link the co-prosecutor's computer to the main screen?
Connecter l'écran principal sur celui des coprocureurs.
The president, the audio and visual unit, please link the screen.
Je prie.
To the computer screen of the co-prosecutor.
Avec l'écran des coprocureurs.
The president, the court officer, can you have this document to be projected on the slide? First, project the first document, says the president.
Projeter le premier document, dit le président.
Your Honor, there seems to be some technical problem. We've been advised by the IT section that next week they'll improve the situation so we don't have to pull out the plug and place it back in again. But it appears it's just arisen on the screen.
Empêche l'affichage du document à l'écran. D'ici la semaine prochaine, ce problème devrait être réglé. C'est ce qu'on nous assure en tout cas.
Is it can you see the document on the screen? Because here on our screens we do not see anything.
Nous ne voyons rien.
Okay. Le président. The document which is being projected on the screen, that is with the year
007272.
My question to you is, do you acknowledge that this is the document from the re-education center in Preiso and that the annotation is yours?
Et qu'il s'agit bien ici de vos annotations.
The accused, Mr. President.
Monsieur le Président.
In this document, there are annotations from two people.
Nous avons des annotations de deux personnes.
Roy's annotation,
à savoir les annotations de Roy,
to me, talking about the father and the mother and the siblings of a contemptible Sock.
La mère, ainsi que de la fratrie du méprisable Sock.
He talked about the owner of the dollars who were about to go to Baden-Baden. President, I do not want to know the details. What I want to know is whether you acknowledge that this is the document coming from S21 and or the re-education center in
Preiso.
The accused, Mr. President,
réponse,
I acknowledge this is the document of S24, and I annotated on this document.
J'ai porté des annotations
the President,
sur ce
court officer,
document.
Can you show the second document on the screen?
Projeté à l'écran le
the accused, you can see the one with the red circle. It said that the pregnant lady were about to deliver, and there were eight of them.
Les femmes enceintes, il y en avait huit, étaient sur le point de donner naissance, d'accoucher.
Do you acknowledge this is an appropriate document? Because just then you acknowledge the first document that it was the document from S24 with your annotation, and this is the second document.
Qu'il s'agissait the bien accused. Quant au premier document,
Mr. President, this is also a document belonging to S24.
Réponse. Monsieur le Président, il s'agit bien là aussi d'un document provenant de S24.
So, do you acknowledge that?
Vous reconnaissez bien que les personnes qui supervisaient S24, vous reconnaissez que parmi les personnes qui étaient envoyées à S24, il y avait des femmes enceintes. L'accusé, Monsieur le Président, c'est vrai. Pouvez-vous poursuivre votre réponse, s'il vous plaît?
The accused, Mr. President.
Réponse.
This is,
Monsieur le Président.
This is a document verifying that there were pregnant women and also the original elements of those who were sent to prison, including the marital transport unit, the water unit in Chamkamon, and those from various divisions, and one person from the energy ministry. So there were various elements.
Divisions et de différents ministères, le ministère de l'énergie. Donc il y
you
avait différents éléments qui étaient envoyés après ça. J'invite l'huissier à enlever ce document de l'écran du rétroprojecteur.
The President.
Le Président.
Can you tell the chamber
pouvez-vous nous dire
the form or the process of sending people
quel était le processus ou la procédure de
who were the family members of the people
who
were arrested and sent to S21 and
smashed? Pour être
what was
écrasé.
The process of sending
quelle
those people to Preiso and how was it done?
I
think there are two ways. One is those people were already sent to S21, but they were not entered yet, only the people who were to be kept in S21 were kept there, and the family would be sent to S24, or alternatively, the husbands would be sent to S21, and the family members would be sent directly to S24,
without going through S21. Can you explain it to us? Sans passer par S21. Est-ce que vous pouvez nous donner un petit peu plus d'explications là-dessus?
The accused, Mr. President.
Monsieur le Président.
Based on my assumptions, I was not. I'm not very clear. It may be that the husband was arrested and sent for a day or two, and later the wives were arrested later and sent to the place marked R. And the security sent them to Presor. Why I made this assumption? Because I remember one of the cases. It is one wait. The standing committee arrested a brother one at the office of the Central Committee on the 2nd of November 1978. About one day or two days later, they arrested the wives of Cheng On and Von Wet's wife at Soramarit Buddhist Institute and sent to the place marked R. And if anyone would send to Presor, they need to first arrive at the place marked R, which is now called the Bihai Radio Station. So this is my conclusion on that case. That's all I can tell, Mr. President. The President, now talking about the working condition, can you tell the Chamber about the aspect and the working conditions and the living conditions of those who were kept at the re-education center?
Centre de rééducation, de ceux qui étaient détenus au centre de rééducation, reprend l'interprète.
The accused, the management, and the supervision of those who were kept there. There was a strict management during the day's work. They were also guarded. The security was not armed, but I did not went there personally. I did not witness that. However, those who guarded those people who were there together with those people, and those who had a problem, they stay in a separate house, and the combatant who guarded it will stay in a separate house, but they bear the guns. But for those who have a problem, have to stay at a separate. Sometime Comrade Hui arrested and kept there a night or two before sending to Phnom Penh, or he detained there two or three nights and later released. But for anyone to be sent to Phnom Penh, he had to have my decision from me so that he can send to S21 or directly to Cheng Ek based on the offense they committed. That's all I can tell you, Mr. President. The President, just now you said that those who were supervised or managed, can you tell us who were the one who kept there at S24? So they called that group was called a prisoner, or what were they called, or just the one who were under your supervision, or those who receive re-education, was there any particular term for that? At S21, they were called as prisoners, but for those who were at prison, did you call them as prisoners, or what was the term used to refer to those people kept at prison? The accused, Mr. President, the term used, it is a countrywide use for these people. They call them as people with some elements. Elements people. One of the surviving documents, and I receive the document. It is.
J'ai reçu ce document. Il s'agit du.
It is the statistics of the general staff ERN 00052 3 19. In this document, line number 13, it reads Office S21, there were 2,327 not included the elements,
sans compter les éléments.
And the notes on the bottom of the page, it reads the statistic of the force surrounding Phnom Penh, there were 30,600. The statistic for there were 43,810 of them, so the elements unit kept at S24, there were 1,300 of them. The term used across the country, they call it the elements unit. It means that it's not clear that they were friend or enemy. Sometimes they slash us in their capacity as an enemy. In some cases, they were loyal to us. So this is what we call the elements unit, or people in the elements units. Thank you.
Des ennemis, mais ce n'était pas très clair. On les désignait par le terme unité d'éléments.
Hello. The President, question. Can you tell us?
Pouvez-vous nous dire?
Or did you know about the assignment for people to supervise those people at S24. So how did that works about, especially those who need to supervise those elements unit or people in those element units? How did it work at that time?
Comment est-ce que les choses fonctionnaient à l'époque?
The accused.
Réponse.
I did not prepare as a list, but in general, I can tell you as follow. They were divided into three different groups based on the true nature and the stance of those people. One group which was considered better or good, another one is fair, and another group was the group that may cause any harm to us. So I would like to tell you that based on my conclusion, based on my understanding on the party line, I can tell you this information.
Parti, je peux vous donner ces informations.
The President, the divisions of the category of people based on the target or the elements under the supervision of Presor, what was the purpose of that division?
Quel était l'objectif de cette division?
the accused, Mr. President. Firstly,
réponse, Monsieur le Président. Tout d'abord,
the first purpose to manage them to do the work and they can rebuild themselves in the working and the respect of the regulation in the group and in the platoon, and they had to follow their superior. This is one of the purpose, the main purpose.
Ça, c'était l'objectif fondamental.
It's only the only purpose to help them work hard for the benefit of the party, for the production
of rice,
and they had to learn to follow the superior and not to be rude or not to oppose the party in any case whatsoever. This is the main purpose of division of the group of people. The president, the consequence of the division of the three categories of group of people at S24 or Presso, were there any impact that signify any the harder work or any severe condition of working or food for the type you say good, fair and a not good element groups. The accused, Mr. President.
De personnes.
I was not there personally,
réponse, Monsieur le Président, but je n'étais pas sur les lieux en
tell
personne,
you that
mais je peux vous
the division in the food ration it was not important. But the more important is about the spy against those people, because the third element that we consider as the bad element, in some case they can cause harm to us, so there was a strict spy or monitoring, and the decision to remove these people to be detained at Phnom Penh is more easier to make decision. It does not need a careful decision
prise de manière
to,
plus
to that. So based on my recollection, I can tell you about this. The President, thank you. Another question. The division into three categories of people, was there any change during the operation? For example, for the people in the good group, if anyone commit any mistake, was sent to any not so good or to the worst group, to the second or the first group, because they build up themselves, was there any criteria to move people from one group to another?
Groupe des personnes nuisibles.
They accused there might be a
réponse.
Case, but from the good categories, more people change from one to the second and to the third, but from the second and the third group to the first is very few of them.
Mais
and from and more people from the third group to Phnom Penh and Chiang Mai.
A été plus de, un nombre plus important de personnes appartenant au troisième groupe
the
a été
President,
emmené
talking
à
about
Phnom Penh,
working hours,
ou à Chiang Mai.
Can you remember and tell us about the working hour for doing the work there? Because they were all had to work from day to day. So can you tell us about that?
Tous les jours. Pouvez-vous nous parler des conditions de travail?
Mr. President.
Réponse, Monsieur le Président.
They did not do any other business rather than the rice production. So when the harvesting ends, they need to dig the canal and the rice paddy dikes, and they need to grow the vegetables and sweet jam in addition to the production, and they need to supply to their units. And their main works were rice productions and the growing of the cassava and sweet jam, and also raising animal to support the units at the center. This is about their works, and talking about working hours, at least 8 hours a day, 8 hours a day. So it is the minimum, and sometimes they need to wake up in the early morning when there's a strong or the strong offensive doing the job. That's all I can tell you. The President, were there any night work for them? The accused, yes, Mr. President, when there's a full moon night work were required.
À la pleine lune,
the President, were there any holidays within a week or within 10 days, or the work continued without any break or holidays?
Comment ça se passait? Y avait-il des jours de, comment ça se
passait? The accused, Mr. President,
l'accusé, Monsieur le Président.
So, from the beginning, there was a break, a one-day break per 10 days, but later, every one of us, including me, we did the work every day. And also, the cadre like me had to do the work every day. That's all I can tell you.
Tout ce que je peux vous dire.
The President,
question.
At that center, were there any animals as a driving force for plowing and for transportation? If yes, how many were there at that time? The accused, Mr. President. If yes, there were very few of that driving force animals. When we need to do the plowing, we need to use hoes to dig the ground in the rice paddy. Most of the time, most combatant unit use the hoes to dig the rice paddy instead of plowing. That's all I can tell you.
Les sillons dans les rizières plutôt que d'utiliser d'autres techniques de labour.
The President, was there any arrangement for plowing that people were used as a driving force like animal at that time?
Êtres humains étaient utilisés comme à la place des bêtes de trait.
The accused, I cannot say no, but there are some unit in Phnom Penh, they use that practice. But if yes, there were a few cases only.
Cette pratique, mais il y a eu quelques cas de ce type.
The President,
question.
Talking about the strict of the discipline or the regulation for those who were in the elements unit or those under the supervision, did they have the right to move around in the territorial area of S24? Could they move out of the area that they were kept?
Se déplacer librement dans la zone où elles étaient
the accused, Mr. President,
gardées.
Nobody had the authority to authorize anyone to leave outside the unit.
Réponse, personne n'avait autorisé de se déplacer practiced. À l'extérieur de l'unité.
And in Phnom Penh,
ni où que ce
I
soit.
Just give you an example.
À Phnom Penh, je vais simplement vous donner un exemple.
The interrogation cadres,
les cadres chargés de,
who were strictly forbidden to leave their unit or to talk to other peoples in various units regarding the importance of or the essence of documents.
De l'importance ou de and la substance
for those
des documents
in Preso, they had no authority to walk or to move to various other units. And the secretary of S24 had no authority to allow anyone to leave the compound. However, they could talk to other elements within the compound, although they might be in other units.
Même si ces personnes appartenaient à d'autres unités.
They could only talk to their workmates, but they could not talk to the rest. So their right of movement was restricted. Their freedom of speech was also restricted only to those within their units. It was just a small chit-chat. And they could only talk in details when it comes to the criticism meetings in the evening.
Et on ne pouvait se parler
so I say again, in general, at both
soir,
locations, at S21 and S24, the right of movement was restricted. The president, let me clarify it.
Question.
So
une
it's
précision.
For both.
Ainsi donc, ceci concerne aussi bien le personnel de S21 à Phnom Penh que le personnel du centre de rééducation à Presort.
Both staffs
dans un cas comme dans l'autre, le personnel
communicate
ne pouvait communiquer.
So there was a clear restriction.
Il y avait des restrictions
secondly,
claires imposées à la communication.
They were not allowed
par ailleurs, ils
to take leave, for example, to go and visit their
prendre
parents.
Prendre des congés et à rendre visite à leur famille,
is this
par
correct?
Exemple. Est-ce bien exact?
The accused,
réponse.
Mr. President. They were not allowed at all to go and visit their parents at their hometown.
Ils n'étaient pas autorisés à rendre visite à leurs parents dans leur village natal.
Let me just say it frankly, even I, myself,
moi-même,
never had the authority to seek for leave from my superior to visit my mother. I never went to Stone. I only went there once after my marriage when I accompanied my mother to go back. So in the entire unit, when I myself behaved like that, nobody else would dare to behave differently.
Enseigne que les autres sur ce plan.
The president.
Question.
At S24 Security Office or Presor.
À S24 au Presor.
Was there a medical unit
y avait-il
for the treatment of the sick?
Où les malades
if
pouvaient
so,
se faire soigner.
What was the medical service like?
Et si oui, à quoi ressemblait ce service médical?
The accused.
Réponse.
The medical health at both locations, at S21 and S24, was almost non-existent, as I already reported to the chamber.
Comme
to the chamber.
Initially,
there was a medic,
au départ, il y avait
a comrade Set.
Set.
Later on, he was removed,
ensuite,
replaced by comrade
emmené,
Tree, and after Tree was removed,
Tree était emmené à son
it was
tour,
hardly to have any medic.
Il n'y a plus eu
I, even I
médicale.
Myself, when I got sick, I had to seek assistance from the two verdicts, from the two medics from the prisoners. One was the nephew of Nguyen Chia, Thorn, and another person from Soviet, Hakpadet. So in conclusion, Not even in S21 in Phnom Penh,
donc même S21
the
Phnom Penh,
health service was very restricted. I did not think about further training
sans
to provide
de
the medical service.
Médicale quelconque.
This is my response, Your Honor. The President, what about the pregnant
question.
Women
and
from
enceintes?
The document I just shown, there were eight pregnant women
j'ai fait montrer qu'il y avait huit
who
enceintes.
Was almost due for the delivery
sur le point d'accoucher.
And the report was in 77 November.
Ce rapport date de novembre 77.
So what happened to them?
Qu'est-il advenu de
how
ces
did
femmes?
They deliver the babies?
Est-ce qu'elles
were
ont
there midwives
y avait-il
with
des sages-femmes
scarce medical resources?
étant donné la pénurie de ressources médicales.
The accused, Mr. President.
Réponse.
For the pregnant women who were to deliver and who were the, in the unit of elements,
pour les
they had no authority to go to deliver the babies at the state hospital outside.
Elle ne peut pas aller à
l'hôpital d'État. They had to deliver the babies
elle
within the compound of S24. I was not sure about the midwife. Could be May who learned some techniques before, or it could be just a traditional midwife. As I said, I did not pay much attention to the medical service.
À cette question des services médicaux.
Neither for my staff and unit, nor for the unit of elements.
Pas plus pour mon personnel et pour S21 que pour
cette unité. And for some wives of the cadres, when they were sick, I sent them to the state hospital.
Malades, je les envoyais à l'hôpital d'État.
So, it was my mistake not to consider
to
provide the medical service.
Réfléchir à cette question des soins.
The president, what about
question.
The food ration? What was it like?
À quoi ressemblaient les rations alimentaires?
People were categorized in three categories.
Les personnes qui se trouvaient à S24 étaient classées en trois
the
catégories.
Serious, the medium,
les
and the less serious group, in order to monitor their activities based on the groups.
And you also said
the second group could
que le deuxième
join
groupe,
the could move into the third group. But then the third group can never move up to the second or the first group.
Mais que les éléments du troisième groupe ne pouvaient jamais monter dans le deuxième ou le premier groupe.
And the question is the food ration for them.
Alors je me demande quelles étaient les
rations alimentaires
comparing
to the prisoners at S21.
À ces différentes catégories et en comparaison avec les prisonniers de S21.
The same? Or was it in a better ration?
Ou est-ce que ces gens étaient mieux nourris?
The accused, Mr. President,
réponse.
Talking about the food ration for the unit of elements, it was better.
Les rations alimentaires étaient meilleures.
The food ration for the prisoners in Phnom Penh were less than
les
those at the
Phnom
unit of elements
Penh
in Presor.
Étaient moins bien nourris que les personnes qui se trouvaient à
Presor. If we talk about the medical service for those elements, it was also better than the medical service for the prisoners detained in Phnom Penh.
À Presor qu'à S21 Phnom Penh.
However, for
Mais
some important prisoners
pour certains prisonniers importants,
with important confessions, the medical service was better than the rest. It was
meilleur.
An exception
c'était,
in order
une
to
exception.
Complete the confession.
Et ce
so for some people in Phnom Penh, their food ration and their medical service was less than those people
les services médicaux
at Presor.
Dispensés à S21 sont en général inférieurs à ceux dispensés à S24. Question.
At the re-education center in Presor,
au centre de rééducation de Presor,
was there any establishment of units such as interrogation or torture team?
Y avait-il une équipe d'interrogateurs et de tortionnaires?
The accused.
Réponse.
Mr. President, from what I can recall, no, there was no such establishment. Why? Because if they were interrogated there, then who would bring the confessions to me for the annotation?
Qui aurait apporté les aveux pour annotation?
Who were the interrogators there?
Et qui aurait interrogé?
And who would appoint them? So I did
qui
not believe there were interrogations or torture at Presor without my authorization.
Et des séances de torture à Presor sans mon autorisation.
President.
Question.
However, there are testimonies of the survivors
de survivants
who said for the third group
qui disent que pour les membres du troisième groupe
they had to receive the interrogation and torture including the beating up and electrocution
des séances de torture notamment des séances d'électrochoc.
Dừng an nơ In the agreed facts for Brésol in paragraph 232, at Brésol, the guards beat the prisoners up and scold the prisoners when they were sick and could not work, and you did not contest to that. Also, at paragraph 233, in one room in prison, the male and female prisoners were interrogated by electrocution, and you did not contest. And for paragraph 234, those people who were sent to prison, when they came, their head were shaved, and they have their skin flayed from the application of electric shocks by the interrogators, and you did not contest to the fact. So these are the agreed facts between you and the co-prosecutors, and this is contradicting to what you just stated. At that time, you did not contest.
Vous n'avez pas contesté les
what is your opinion on what I have just read on the agreed facts?
Alors, que pouvez-vous nous dire maintenant de ces
regarding
faits
the Brésol in
relatif à
Brésol, point 232, 233 and 234,
233 et 234.
The accused. Réponse. I would like to clarify that the interrogation might have happened. However, it would have happened without my appointment. It's possible that Comrade Hui asked others to interrogate before they were sent to S21. And the electrocution was a separate matter. I do not believe there were such incidents there because there were limited generators. So in conclusion, the interrogation there might have happened.
S'il y a eu
if it did,
peut-être.
It was without my authorization.
Mais en tout cas, sans mon autorisation.
And in addition, there were no reports or confessions sending to me for
annotation.
So I do not contest to the possibility that Comrade Hui might have done this without my knowledge.
Cet interrogatoire à mon insu.
The President, at the re-education center at Brésol, were there prison staff who were disciplined and included in the units of elements under the supervision of the prison staff?
Personnel ont été à leur tour intégrés à l'unité des
the
éléments.
Accused, Mr. President.
Réponse.
The people who re-educated them to supervise them, if they made another mistake or offense, they would not be included into the elements. For a serious offense, it would be reported to the upper echelon and they would be brought to Phnom Penh.
Si le récidivé, rapport était fait, ils vont les amener à Phnom Penh.
The President.
Question.
The people who were arrested and sent to S21 including those who were directly sent to Chiang Ai. Also, that included the staff of the re-education center in
Brésol
and those people within the unit of elements. Altogether, how many of them? Can you provide a rough
combien
estimate?
Y a-t-il eu de cas de ce genre? Est-ce que vous pouvez nous donner une estimation?
The accused.
Fut-elle grossière?
For those elements who were interred into Phnom Penh, there were more than 100 of them.
Il faut compter plus d'une centaine.
In total, within that three-year period, there were more than 100 of them.
Plus d'une centaine.
Separately, for the staff of the combatant unit supervising the work in Prisol, there were less than 100 of them. Because in total, all the staff in Prisol who were detained, there were only more than a little bit more than 100 altogether. On paragraph 190, it reads, at least 571 people, including the people and the S24 staff, were arrested and sent from S24 to Dulslang, and you did not contest
to this fact.
So the figure is far from what you said.
Mais vous donnez maintenant un chiffre très différent.
Because here it mentions a clear figure, 571.
Ici, au moins 571.
What
personnes.
Is your comment on this point?
Que pouvez-vous dire de
because the figure is so different.
Puisque vous en donnez maintenant un autre très différent.
The accused.
Réponse.
One is the figure. And yes, I respect the figure.
Oui,
and the other one is my recollection. It might not be as accurate as the real figure. So yes, I acknowledge the real figure.
Réel. Donc, je ne conteste pas ce chiffre qui est donné.
The president.
Question.
I did not ask who made the decision to arrest the staff at
qui the security office at S24
or Preso, because you already answered to that. Who was overawed made that decision? However, for the operation of the arrest of people,
je m'intéresse maintenant à la façon dont on procédait aux arrestations
and to send them from Preso
et dont on transférait les personnes arrêtées
to S21 in Phnom Penh,
Phnom Penh,
or who were sent directly to Chiang Ek,
ou encore directement à Chiang Ek.
Which unit was responsible for such operation?
De ces opérations.
The accused, Mr. President.
Réponse.
The task was ordered, was decided by me, and I ordered Comrade Ho to implement my order, and of course it would fall under the special unit.
Unité spéciale qui se
the President, in general, was the operation conducted
général,
during the day or during the night time?
De jour ou de nuit?
The accused,
réponse.
It was within the same unit, so I believe it was done during the daytime.
Que cela se faisait deux jours.
The arrest of Comrade Hui was also done during the daytime.
Comrade Hui faisait les arrestations deux jours.
I ordered the people
je
who had to arrest Comrade Hui during the daytime under the pretext
à
that
Hui.
He was called for training or for work assignment. So I believed the more possibility would be that the operation was conducted during the daytime rather than the night time.
Une convocation, une réunion ou à des
Mr. President, the arrest of Non Hui or
Non
Israel.
De nuit. Question. Vous parlez de
was his wife or children also arrested and brought along with him?
Maintenant, est-ce que sa femme et ses enfants ont
the
également
accused,
été arrêtés
Mr. President,
et
when
réponse.
I ordered for the arrest, I only ordered for the arrest of Comrade Hui.
Je n'ai ordonné l'arrestation que de Hui.
And for his wife and children,
enfants,
it would be decided by Comrade Hui.
C'est Hui.
The president, so it means the wife of Hui Srai, who was the chairman of the
Prisol.
And a
question,
member, actually, he was a member of the S21 committee in charge of S24. His wife and children were also arrested and smashed. Is that
et
correct?
Sa femme et ses enfants ont
the accused,
été arrêtés,
Mr. President,
exécutés,
that is correct.
Réponse, oui, c'est exact.
Comrade Hui was arrested just 1 month before the 6th of January.
Avant le 6 janvier,
he was arrested on the 6th of December 78, and Comrade Kuhn was probably arrested 1 day after, along with the children,
également
with
sa
the son,
et ses enfants, son fils en l'occurrence.
The president.
Question.
What was the ground for the arrest of Nun Hoi, alias Huisre? When you addressed several times, there was one fault that he allowed his messenger or the one who the radio operator fled away. Was it the main ground of his arrest? My question is that the incident happened at that time. Who reported to you, or how did you know about that?
Comment avez-vous connaissance de cet incident? Qui vous en a fait rapport?
The accused, Mr. President. The ground that led to the arrest of Comrade Hui. There were several grounds, but I forgot. The key ground of the arrest, because his radio operator fled.
Son opérateur radio a pris la fuite.
So the series of facts or incident based on my observation and monitoring by me and Hall against Comrade Hui.
Vous avez pu constater qu'il y a eu plusieurs incidents, plusieurs problèmes.
And therefore, what became known to me, the incident in relation to Comrade Hui, and when his radio operator fled, it was reported to me, and I looked at that report at. It is not reasonable, and then I reported to the upper echelon, and Nun Hui, and I request the upper echelon to arrest Nun Hui. I requested from Uncle Nun, and he agreed to that. But based on my several reported to him, but. Uncle Nguyen requested to see Comrade Hui, including myself, Ho, and him. So when the upper echelon understand more better about Comrade Hui and then the decision, would come. But I would like to tell you that the story that I remember and the main ground is that he allowed his radio operator to flee.
Radio s'enfuir.
The president,
question.
When some people or the staff were removed, including those who were in the re-education center at Presor and those who were in the elements unit under the supervision at Presor and later sent to be executed at Chung Ek. So my question is that how many times of that kind of arrest and execution and the list of people who were taken from Presor to Chung Ek, how did the list prepared for that purpose?
Et comment établissait-on les listes des personnes à emmener ainsi?
The accused, in real practice, I do not know well about that. About the list and how many times of operation, that I can tell you, but I can understand in principle. So any arrest against the combatant, there must be approval from me. This is the right of the combatant. And for any arrest of the people in the elements unit, especially in the third group, I did not feel interested in that arrest. I assigned the subordinate to do that. And I don't know well about how many times an operation against those people in the group. The president, so we can say that the taking away of people from praise all to Chung Ek. Would there be any case that there were no lists, those victims were not on the common list of the people who were sent and killed?
Sont peut-être pas sur les listes dont nous avons connaissance maintenant.
The accused, I dare not confirm for sure,
je ne peux pas
but
vous confirmer
I
ça pour sûr.
Can say that it might be in they were also in the common list of
mais je crois
the people.
Quand même que ces noms devraient se trouver sur la liste commune.
For those who were
question.
Sent for re-education at Brayshaw that you call the elements in the element units, were
et
any of them were released? What were the criteria for their release and who made the decision for that release?
Une éventuelle libération et qui décidait
the accused.
D'une relâche.
There were no release, as I told you earlier.
Non, personne n'a été
S-24 was not
relaxé.
The same as M-13B.
S-24
at
ça de
M-13B, sometimes people detained 1 week or two and later released. So S-24, none
S-24
of the victims were released in other than the 30 people that I told you, and most or people in the elements unit were sent to Chung Ek or S-21. The President, thank you. Now it is time for us to take a morning break. The Chamber would like to take a 20-minute break and we will come back after that to continue our proceeding.
Nous reprendrons dans 20 minutes.